Here you go. Thank you.
Dear Heavenly Father, I lift up these people, Isaac Valentira and DeAndre Robinson. I lift them up to you and I ask for you to show them the importance of repentance and the beauty of repentance. I ask that you open their eyes to the truth and that you cleanse them of all unrighteousness and that you allow them to meet and to know your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and that you help them along the way and lead them to a path of recovery and beauty in life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.
Hey, yeah. What's your name, ma'am?
Marianne.
All right. Marianne's helping me today. Several years ago, she fell in love with some guy. What was his name?
Fred.
Fred. Okay. That's normally people don't fall in love with anybody the name of Fred. But it happened in this case, a miracle. They had two kids, and Fred got massively infected with demons. How did that happen? Was he on drugs?
Yes.
Okay. He went on drugs, and of course that's a highway for demonic intrusion. They just rush in, particularly meth. That's the super drug. And then he started beating her. And then he went to prison. What year was that?
2005.
2005, went to prison. And then he had a counseling appointment. And then he got out what year?
He just got out this year.
Got out in March. Okay. And then she developed anxiety disorder issues, correct?
Yes.
And she started having strange feelings in her tummy and some kind of, hands, vibrating hands.
Yeah, my feet.
Vibrating feet.
And panic attacks.
And what do those feel like?
When I go to the store, I can't get off my car sometimes. Coming here, I struggle to get here.
You go to the store and you have trouble getting out of the car?
Yes.
You were kind of scared to come here today?
Yes.
Okay. What's going on there? Real easy deliverance case. Right? That's a piece of cake. He beating on her. The fear spirits got in, right? And then he went to prison, so the demons kind of back off, and now he's out. And so now they're manifesting again. Right?
Yeah.
Last night at the altar, did you happen to see those two guys praying for people? That guy right there and that guy? Guy with a hat on right there. Bass Pro Shop guy. See that guy there? Kind of like, he looks Asian, but he looks white, kind of a mix. They were killing it last night, and they're from San Francisco. Went well? Yeah, so they're going to go back to San Francisco and do that all the time.
That'll be a full-time job.
And a what?
That'll be a full-time job.
They're going to have a full-time job, at a minimum part-time, blasting away at the demons in San Francisco, those two guys. What happened there was one of the reasons I'm here. I try my best to help people get their gifts going. And then it's hard to get a gift going if you don't have an opportunity to use it. So I give people little, things to do. And then the Spirit of God goes, hey, see that? You did that here, you can do that anywhere with anybody. And you don't need Brother Mike. He's a non-issue. That's how it works. Yeah. You want to help as many people as you can get going in their ministry. For example, these three. When they came here, they had nothing. That guy over there, there he is. Carter guy. He's booming. If you give people an opportunity and they want to take it, they'll grow fast, you know. The Spirit of God knows how to train quickly. He gets them going fast. And there's another one who started her training last night. There she is. That woman. Where's she at? Where's your...
She's riding horses.
Partner in riding horses. Okay, well, we failed. Now, an older woman came with her, and the older woman brought her. Yeah. But it was a trick. The Holy Ghost jumped on her. Okay. He tricks people all the time. He tells, hey, why don't you take that person in and get them healed? Then he jumps on them. Brilliant. Of course. Yeah, so she started her journey last night. Got her tongues fixed. You're ready to go. Okay? You learn in increments, step by step. It's almost very, very rarely does somebody go from here to there. Real quickly, very rare. It happens on a very rare occasion, but not very often. Yeah, learn to grow, okay? See that guy sitting right there? Look at him, that guy. When he first started coming here, you know, he did a very poor job. Confused, what's going on? How am I supposed to behave? Last night, he turned into a freak. He's attacking the devil, driving devils out of him. It was wonderful. And so that's what you want to do. You do it first, and then you get them to do it. Because you can't live with them. You can't go home with them. People have to learn self-deliverance. If they don't, they usually get reinfected, and they keep coming back to you all the time, year in and year out, wanting you to, quote, deliver them. And that's not what's supposed to happen. Everybody has to renew their mind and repent on their own. You can't do it for them. The lady at the altar last night with the curly hair, what was her name? She was sitting back there. She'd been at the Dream Center. Did you happen to see her? She was really infected with spirits. She had been through some satanic activity. She wouldn't say her name.
Yeah.
Well, she's got, you know, really bad schizophrenia plus stuff. Well, this guy here has got it. What's your name again?
John.
Okay. So his condition is not as bad as hers last night. Because there was witchcraft involved in that. He's got drug-induced schizophrenia, which is spreading the country. It's all over the place now. Particularly with this pot coming from Mexico, it's so potent that people are getting schizophrenia and psychosis after just a few times using it. It's so bad. And so meth is usually the one here that does it. If you're on meth, that's really bad. Okay? So what he has to learn is what I've been trying to get him to learn. These spirits get in your head and they start talking, or sometimes they talk outside your head, talking here. And if you listen to them, those thoughts become yours.
When I get my mind goes crazy, I tell them that bind and rebuke come in the name of Jesus Christ.
Okay, so he used to listen to him. So I need to get you converted over to seeing them as your enemy and not listen to them. Because if
laugh
they try to say, I'm your friend.
Do funny things.
Yeah, but before he was saying, he would listen to them. And if you listen to them, they take it as you like them and you're their friend.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter whether you say, I don't like them, I hate this, I don't want to do this. They don't care. As long as you're listening to them, okay, what you do is more important than what you say. Talk is
cheap.
They do stuff, crazy stuff, like when I first was a Christian, they try to tell you that you need to buy like 10 different Bibles and try and get you confused.
Things. Yeah, that's right. Now, he's not on the phase two yet, as you can see. And the second thing they do is they try to get you to remember everything they did to you in the past. Hey, you remember when I used to tell you to go run out in traffic? Remember when I used to tell you to do cartwheels? Remember when I used to tell you to do this and that? Remember that? Yeah, why don't you tell that counselor of yours, tell her what happened. Oh, gosh, they used to make me do this and that. Yeah, I used to pick my nose and then I used to eat it in public. Oh, it was so embarrassing. I can't believe they made me do it. As long as you keep rehearsing their victories, they own you. Anybody see that? Professional athletes are tormented their entire lives. Over what? Close losses. 25 years from losing the Super Bowl, the guy can tell you every instant of that play, of how the ball was tipped, it was a freak, some guy hit it, some guy fell down, and it fell.
Is it more than regrets? It's just regrets that you keep regressing over and over.
Yeah, I kind of like regrets, but it's regrets on steroids. Regular people have regrets. This is actually rehearsing supernatural activity, victories the demon did to them in the past. And they tell it to you, to you, to you, to you, to you. 15 years later, they're told you about it. They told you about it. That cycle has to be snapped.
When you're saying the first way to do that is repentance and brokenness?
Well, yeah, but repentance of listening to them and repeating what they do.
And if it keeps going and going and going, you just keep...
You have to stop that cycle.
Right.
Of what you're doing.
By being repetitively rebuking them, or...
And not listening to them, not receiving them. So if you're telling everybody what the demons did to you 5 years ago, stop.
Or currently.
In the same way abusers do the same thing. Oh my God, they did this. Oh, I was in third grade and the guy came in.
So you fight the lie with the truth? That's what I'm asking. Exactly what you do. Fight the lie with the truth when it's going and going and going like it is for him in his head constantly. He can't even read the word without the interruption. I'm speaking for him, but I'm witnessing it, okay? You start by not listening. How?
Well, what he does, he said, what do you say? I bind and rebuke those thoughts. See, he's fighting back. If you just listen to them, they assume you're their friend.
What do you do? Like, I got a situation with them right now where they know I'm trying not to listen to or interact with them, but they'll speak in a way where it actually sounds, they'll put the thought in my head and then speak out loud behind it, and try to make me think that it's my thought, but I can be doing anything and they'll speak over it and they'll take my attention right away. And I'm kind of focused on nothing, trying to pay attention to nothing, but I'll hear them in the background.
Mm-hmm. See? He's not fighting back. They're doing whatever they want to do.
Well, how do I fight back against it? It's by not listening
in your head.
Well, you would do what he just said. You would
say in your head.
Go through a process of learning these scriptures.
You can also say and reject these thoughts as not mine.
I reject this. I renounce this. You got to show resistance.
I do.
What do you do?
Well, I'll say that the thoughts aren't mine, but then they'll get me with it and they'll start playing a buzzer in my head.
That's good.
You interacted with me.
Yeah, you said the thoughts are not yours, then you go to the next level. It's a process of fighting back.
Okay.
That's the first process.
I know for me, when I get thoughts that repeat, that are not healthy for me, I had a doctor at one point tell me to crumble into a ball, throw it to a trash can. That's one. The other thing I've been doing lately, however, is I've been praying to Jesus to disconnect that button. So when they push that button, it doesn't work anymore. So that's what I've been doing, is praying, Lord, please just disconnect that button. That button doesn't work anymore. And it takes a few times, but after a while, button don't work no more.
Question, I rebuke them. How many times a day is necessary to do that? Because they don't stop.
Well, initially, it's all day.
They'll turn it into a game.
Yeah.
Say rebuke, now say rebuke. Rebuke,
yeah.
Say the.
Yeah.
I mean, they repeat scripture after me.
Mm-hmm.
I can't even get a thought out.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have a thought, and they'll erase my memory like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's clear.
Yeah. Yeah, I understand. You got to start somewhere. Mm-hmm. And it's a growth process.
When you get a breakthrough in the deliverance, when things get worse, so when they start attacking you more, it's not a red flag. It's actually a green light, because you're going to keep fighting it, because eventually when you keep fighting it, they're gonna stop.
Right.
Yeah.
So what you're going to do is go through the miracle list. You have a copy of it?
Yes.
Okay.
I think I do.
Okay.
Then you haven't been doing it.
Okay, we'll get it to you before you leave. There's one for mental illness. Can you get in that before he leaves? Okay, and you got to stay with that list.
Okay.
There's no way to get healed without doing that list.
She spent a whole hour with him last night. And thank you, Jennifer. Yeah. It's not easy to sit through.
Yeah, what did Jennifer tell you to do?
Not pay attention, not interact with him.
Okay, what else?
I can't remember.
You remember what you told him?
Do the miracle list.
do the list.
Come out of a dream and stop listening to the demons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to turn on them. You can't be laughing at their jokes or.
Well, I try not to. And
right. You got
to
keep trying because.
No, you got to stop it.
They're friends with them. They ain't leaving.
Yeah.
So the other
right.
night when Rick was talking, he was right on. He's really good. And he had a real, John really listened and really got interactive and got some good feedback from it. And he was going to go up for prayer. And he goes, we got to go. And I was like, why? And he says, because the demons told me if I go up there, they're going to put a smile on my face because they control the muscles in my face.
No, that's a textbook example.
One of the fears that came in was he heard a podcast by you that said one time I was doing deliverance and the person was smiling at me,
mm-hmm.
and it showed they weren't ready.
Uh-huh.
So he was afraid that he would go up and get rejected.
Yeah, see, that's what he's got to overcome.
Oh, okay.
What he just said, he has to do the opposite.
Yeah.
The demons told me to stay in my seat, and they hit me with fear because I'm going to smile when I go up there. I'm not listening to them. I'm hunting for Jesus. I'm going to get help.
No.
See that?
Nothing like that.
What was it?
I listened to you when I go to sleep, and I put my earphone in, and it said, if the person smiles at you during the deliverance, shut the deliverance down, because that means they got a hook in you.
Find out what it is,
and
right.
The demon started immediately discussing, well, where's the hook at? Where do we got the hook in?
Well, that was him. That's the hook, talking to you.
Yeah.
Okay.
But they heard that, and it put me, it didn't, it put a little fear in me, because I was like, crap, you know, this is going to take a little, it's going to be a little bit harder. But I can't even.
Okay, well, what he's saying is exactly what we've been saying. He's got to stop listening to them. He needs to get a mental divorce. Because if you listen to these demons, they will never leave. Ever. And you will be older than me when you die. And they'll be talking to you as you hit the floor. Bye-bye. Bonk. You will never be healed if you don't stop listening to them. Using God's word and your anointing, you can stop. Because you have free will. For example, you came here today. They didn't want you to come here, but you did. Right? They have free will.
And I told
him, he what?
He goes, I can't get deliverance. And I said, it is deliverance
nope.
when you just step your foot in here. It's deliverance when you go up front for prayer.
Now, as soon as he said that word, I can't get deliverance, if the thought is negative, it's not from God, right? And that's when you catch it. That was a lie. Got you.
So what, do you feel like you can get deliverance?
I never said I can't get deliverance.
Oh, what did he say?
I have complete faith that God's going to do it for me, that he's not going to leave me this way, and it's going to end. I'm being patient with it. I know I'm going to get deliverance.
Okay.
Yesterday when I was up there, I didn't even catch it. I just, all of a sudden, I had a feeling and just said, leave. And
yeah, he said leave.
Angry, yeah, and I left. And I didn't even catch it until I was in the, like, home and thinking about it, but they got me.
Yeah, well, that was temporary. You're going to get them now.
Hey, Julie made some really good videos on exactly how to do those miracle lists in order, so just watch those videos. Both of you guys in order, and she just goes really simply how to do each one. So
where is that one?
That's on the website. So those are
and it's under Julie.
Julie's teaching.
Steps to freedom.
So number four is the one you need that the most help with. That's the one on the thoughts. So it just goes over it exactly step by step.
Okay.
It's a process.
Listen to it over and over.
How many years were you on drugs?
15.
15 years. Okay, so you were on drugs for 15 years, and you came in here and you want to be healed in 2 hours. Okay, that's not going to happen. For example, let's say Smith Wigglesworth came in here and blew all the demons out of that guy's head. Bang! They're gone. He'd be reinfected in about 4 days. Why? He hadn't renewed his mind. He doesn't have the word.
Yes, they have to come in with the first Facebook minister. They don't know what they're doing, most of them. They cast everything out in one session. They came right back 3 days later.
Right, because, you can't keep spirits out of you if you don't have God's word and you haven't renewed your mind. It doesn't work. Everybody, non-mentally ill or mentally ill, doesn't matter. Everyone's required to renew their mind. All of us. We're all the same. So, if you can not be discouraged, you'll get healed so much quicker. But their job is to get you discouraged and to frustrate you.
Yeah.
And they're really good at it.
What do you think the family's role is when something like this happens?
Families are the target. The demons get into
the person as well.
That's hard to do because those demons are after you.
Oh, yeah.
They got a target on your back. See? Hear that?
Yeah.
Did you hear that, what she said? Thank you. She said, I want to punch him every time. That's exactly what they want. They're partying in that guy's head.
Yeah.
See,
I don't, but.
She doesn't. Doesn't matter. They don't care. I couldn't care less. They've got her doing what they want her to do. They want her to feel like they want her to feel. So the sick person and the family attacks all of the other ones. That's the purpose of it. They're plants. And there's an example of it. They want that woman beaten into the ground. His demons hate you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I know they do. I hate them, and the things I tell them and pray against, I can only, you know, when I pray for John, I can only pray in the Spirit.
Perfect. That's exactly what God wants you to do. Well done, sweetheart.
There is no prayer.
Yeah, in fact, see how hurt she is right now? Look at her. She's got a good heart. She loves him. She wants him healed. See that? That's what they're after. They want to crush her heart. Right?
Right.
All right. Go ahead and stand up.
Thank you, Lord.
Me? Yeah. All right. Close your eyes, hon.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Hey, will you hold her glasses? Yeah, girl. Thank you, Lord. All right. Father, see this beautiful woman here? Look at her. She's loves. She loves. And the devil hates her love, particularly for him. And they're trying to whittle her down to nothing. Emotionally. And later on, they're going to make her sick. She's going to come down with strange illnesses, weird body pains, joint issues, organ stuff. They're leading her down the road, and it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. We're on to them. We know what they're doing, and they're going to lose. They're going to lose because she is going to change right now. She's going to release him to God. She can't help him or heal him. She can't fix him. She doesn't have any ability to do that. This is way above her pay grade as it is mine. And therefore, her Heavenly Father wants her to release him to him. Let me have the boy.
Yes.
And you release him out of here. Would you be willing to do that?
Oh, yeah.
You would? All right, close your eyes there. Raise your hands. Thank you, Jesus. Dear Lord Jesus, I'm going to release my loved one to you.
Yes.
Because I know you can fix him. I cannot fix him. I cannot fix him. I'm going to give him away. I'm going to, so to speak, lay him down at the altar of God's mercy and sacrifice him to my Heavenly Father of my own free will. I take a breath and blow. Okay, come on out now. Come out of there. Keep blowing. Let's go. Worry, fear of his future. Sadness over his condition. All the pain of 15 years of drug abuse beating down on my soul. All these broken tears I released on his behalf. All the nights I rolled back and forth in bed, tormented by what was going to happen to him. All the pain I went through that nobody cared about. All the times I was left alone without any help with him or anything else. All of this I'm going to release to my Savior today. I'm going to let it go in Jesus' holy name right now. Okay? Come on out. Every demon that transferred into me from him over worry and fear, I want out for the rest of my life. I am not going to die before my time. I'm not going to become an old woman years before my time. It's not going to happen. And that these demons are not going to steal my joy anymore. It's not going to happen. Let her go now. Come on out. Come on. Come on out. Come out of there.
Let her go.
Come out. Every meth demon tormenting her. My God, why does he have to take drugs? Why won't he change? Why won't he turn his life over to the Lord? How come? All this torment in my soul. Why won't anybody help me? I release it all right now. Now in Jesus' name, come on out. Come out of her. Lift off of her. Regrets, burdens, carrying burdens for him. No more. Not doing it anymore. No more. I'm going to release it right now by faith. Just do it by faith. I give him to the Lord and I let him go. I let him go. Come on. You're among friends here. And we're all praying for you. Just let him go. He's not your responsibility anymore. It's your Heavenly Father's job now, not yours. I want my son out of me, and all the heartache and all the tears I shed over his life. The devil was, demons were using him to crush me. And I ask you to forgive this, her son right now for all he'd done to her. Because the Bible says if you dishonor your mother or your father, a curse falls on you. If you can't see a curse on this guy, you're blind. All this horror hit this guy because he dishonored his mother. Wow. And I ask you now, Lord, to have him repent of this right now. I repent, Lord Jesus, of hurting my mother. I am so sorry. I'm so sorry for what I've done to her.
Sorry for what I've done to her.
He apologizes all the
time. Does he? Did you let him go? Did you let him go?
Oh, yeah.
You sure?
Yes. Yes. He knows. Yeah.
Did you do it now?
Yes.
Okay.
I surrendered.
Huh?
I surrendered.
You did? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Good. All right. Honey, will you stand up? Go ahead. There you go. All right, now we're going to get Fred out of there.
Thank you, Lord.
He's in her tummy right here. Remember that?
Thank you.
Okay. Lord, we all lift Fred up to you today.
Yes,
Lord. And we're going to ask you for a miracle. I want you to go hunt Fred down. I know he beat her because the demons told him to. I know that was the devil. Nobody just on their own beats up their wife. That just doesn't happen. I know it's him. Satan. He told him to beat her. He told him to hurt her. He told him to hurt her because Satan wanted a fear spirit to get in her stomach and torment her for the rest of her life till she dies. Well, that's not going to happen. So we're all going to forgive Fred. Every time he slapped her, every time he beat her, every time her abuser hurt her, every single time, we're going to forgive him. We're going to forgive her. Right now, go ahead. dear Lord, I'm sorry I had hatred for him years ago. I'm sorry I had ought for him. I'm sorry. I am so sorry. Oh God, I ask you to bless him because you told me to love your enemies. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who despitefully use you. And I'm doing that right now. And I'm going to release Fred, just like this mother released her daughter, her son. I'm going to release Fred right now in Jesus' name and turn him over to you, Lord. Turn him over to you right now. In the name of the Lord. I forgive him. Did you do it? Can you forgive him?
Yes.
You can? Did you do it? Okay. Well, that's it. Fred, come out of her tummy. Stop shaking her hands. He gives her shakes. Come out of her tummy now. She forgot. Here he comes. Go on out, Fred. Freddy, come out of there. Freddy, come on out. Hurry up. Let's go. Come out of there. Come on out. You know, I just taught that schizophrenic phase one in the sanctuary. He's happy as a clam. Assuming clams are happy. But here's phase one on the mentally ill. Demons are like checkers, as I said before. Each person moves. If you move twice, you're cheating. So here's what happens. He was sitting there, and the demon started beeping in his head. Beep, 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 beep. He gets up and walks out. Then he walks back in, sits down. Anybody see that?
Yeah.
Okay. So I knew what was going on. So I took him out in the sanctuary. I said, now listen, this is phase one. This is what you've got to do. Whenever they move, if they don't have to pay for it, they'll move again. And again. Okay? It's like shopping in San Francisco. Okay? So you're on social media. We're going to hit Walgreens, 1 o'clock, 6 o'clock. 150 guys show up, men and women show up at Walgreens, run in the store, run out with stuff, arms full of stuff. Why do they do that? They don't have to pay for it.
They can.
Okay? They don't have to pay. Demons are exactly the same. If they do something to you and they don't have to pay for it, they'll do it again. They'll cheat. And so when they move, you got to move. If you don't, they'll do it again. Can you hear me? If they have to pay for something, they'll wait a minute. There's a price to beep, beep, beep. So I gave him a pocket Bible to carry with him always, you know. He went through Psalm 150, praise you the Lord. I said, now listen, when they move, now you move. You listen to this, boom, praise you the Lord.
Praise God.
And he's going back and forth there. I'm training him. So what you got to do is take them one step at a time. You can't give them two steps or three. It won't work. Because they got focus problems. And so I just spent 20 minutes having him walk back and forth in there, reading that psalm and praising the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. It's exactly the same as San Francisco shopping.
Mm-hmm.
it's no different. If they have to pay for it, they'll stop it. They don't have them anymore. When I was a kid, back in the old days, they used to have what they called chalkboards. Mm-hmm. And people used to have chalk instead of this thing. It was chalk, real chalk. And the teacher would get up there, and sometimes the chalk would break. And their nails would... And I'm sitting there in second grade, whatever, I'm getting the creeps. It goes all over me. Oh, I don't know why that's bothered me so much. It was a weird, no, I can't even replicate it. I got the super creep. Oh, I'd cringe. Why'd you do that? That's what they're doing. Beep, 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 beep. Oh, you're beeping me now? I want to beep you now. They'll stop it. Crystal, did you hear me? If you let them get away with something, they'll do it again. Like they have been the last 6 months now. Crystal. They move, you move. Checkers. They move, you move. If you don't move, then they'll move again because they cheat. Did you hear me? I gave her a big four. Four things to do to make them pay. Remember those? Where are they? Tell them.
To make them pay, I quote victory scriptures. I sing in tongues or pray in tongues.
Praise God.
Worship the Lord if, praise and worship the Lord if also I like to worship and praise the Lord. And to try and not even think about the thoughts in my head. And I try and read scriptures as well that it's in, I have in my big four, I write scriptures for the thoughts that I have in my head. I switch them up and I put the scriptures that replace it in my big four to help refer myself to them every day when I read it.
Does that work?
Yes.
What do you do, Crystal, when they talk to you? Okay, see the difference? Notice that? That's why you're not getting any better? Because ignoring it doesn't work? They just come back again?
I lost my gift of tongues.
You what?
I lost my gift of tongues.
You lost your gift of tongues? Did you hear that? They told her a big fat lie and made up a fantasy, and she believed it. She's not getting any better. She's not following the protocol. Did you hear what she said? Can you do that? If you just ignore them, they'll come back. You can't get them out. Okay? By the way, everything we're talking about here applies to everybody.
Praise God.
They do the exact same to everybody.
Yes, Lord.
It's not as pronounced because you're not mentally ill, but it's the same process. Right, Mike? It's the exact same process. And if you don't fight back, now you can't, what he said is not going to work. Okay? It's a temporary patch job. He's just patching his mind. Right? Patch. I'm going to take that thought and pretend it's a piece of paper and throw it in the trash. No, that is not going to get rid of demons. That's not going to work. Because they'll go, okay, well, let's have about 5,000 of these all year. Just keep throwing that. No. You want them out of there. They're squatters. And you want them out of your head.
Yes, Lord. Praise God.
Ignoring them will not work. They don't care if you ignore them. Because they're going to come back later. They're going to keep coming back until you do something about it. You've been listening to this, sweetie?
Yes.
No. Stop. Come out.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
That'll stop.
Praise God.
If they got to pay for something, they'll stop it. You follow me for San Francisco?
Yeah.
You're going to be facing this constantly up there. There's mentally ill people in San Francisco you can't believe. It's like flocks of birds. It's exactly the same thing. They're in their brain, putting those thoughts in their mind. And because they don't have to pay for it, they're living there rent free. Why not stay there? Right? They're comfortable in your head. What did Jennifer tell you to do when they talked to you?
I don't remember. I suffer memory loss.
Did you hear what she said?
Yes.
She thinks she's got memory loss now. Everything they tell her, she buys. They don't have to pay for nothing. They've moved in. There's nothing wrong with her. I mean, this is Fantasy Island on steroids. I realize this sounds crazy, but this is what happens during the tribulation. Hopefully we're gone by then. The whole planet ends up like this. Everybody's under mind control.
Oh yeah, they have a system worked out. People's memories declining.
You stay here. See, they told her to get up and leave. Did you see that? What did he say to you? Sweetheart, what did he say to you? He said something to you and you got up. What was it?
They kept making me feel rejection.
Did you hear that? She felt rejected. If you keep letting them make up fantasies, they just keep making them up. What'd you say?
I was saying they had the system working now with all the electronics and stuff. They're trying to program people. They have memory issues. When they do a lot of psychological stuff, it's showing people can't remember things.
Yeah.
People are going to be like fish.
Yeah. Who needs prayer? Yes, there we go. Yeah, good. Come on up, guys. Thank you, Jesus. Come over here. You need prayer or you gonna pray? Come on, help me pray. Which is it?
I need prayer.
Pray in prayer. Stay there. All right. Thank you, Jesus. All right. All right, here we go. All right, let's close our eyes now. We got some really powerful demons here today, but the Holy Ghost is so powerful, he makes them look like, I ain't got the words. I don't have the words.
Like infants in a battle.
Good. Is everybody here hearing thoughts in their minds? Are you? Okay, come down here.
So not me?
No, yeah, you do. You stay right there. Yes, you come down here with her. Okay. All right, now listen. Your ultimate goal is to get these things out of there. Correct? All right. If they don't have to pay for anything, they keep repeating it. Over and over again. If they have to start paying for it, they'll stop, permanently stop, right? Because what you want is freedom, not patching all the time. That's a coping mechanism. That doesn't get them out of there.
Well, that's how it originally started, but I've evolved since then.
You've evolved to what?
I said that, you know, praying to have Jesus break the line to that button.
Yeah, okay. You know, that's a good start, but that's not getting them out of there. That's a coping mechanism, see? He's saying break that off. Well, then they come back later. Now we want them out, and they have to pay for what they're doing. That doesn't make them pay. It just makes them stop. Yeah? There's a difference if I tell her to stop doing something or if I punch her in the mouth. Right? True? You're going to be a mouth puncher. in Jesus' name.
No.
You're going to make them pay a fat lip, black eyes, or whatever it is. That's what you're going to do. All right, close your eyes now. Let's pray. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I give you thanks for these saints who have come up. Six glorious saints have come up right now to be healed and delivered. And they want freedom. And they're willing to fight for it. They're willing to fight for it. Now, Spirit, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we renounce everything you do, every negative thought you put in my mind. I renounce every negative emotion you pump into my soul. I renounce every spirit of rejection calling me a failure and a loser. I renounce every false word you ever put in my mind, every lie you ever told me. I hate it. And you are going to have to pay for it. You're going to have to pay for what you've done to me, all the years you stole from me, all the friends you stole from me, my family, my life, my career, everything. You're going to have to pay for everything. You're not going to get away with anything anymore. I'm going to make you pay in Jesus' mighty name right now. I command you by the authority of the Word of God and the blood of Jesus. I command you by the authority of the Word of God, come out. I command you to come out of my body right now. Come out of my body right now in Jesus' holy name. Come on. Tell him to go. I'm going to make you pay for what you did to me. I'm going to make you pay, you liar. You filthy liar. How dare you treat me like this? How dare you lie to me like this? How dare you? Come out in Jesus' holy name. Every spirit of fear hiding in my body, I command you out right now in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' mighty name. Come on out. Come out of there. Come out right now. Take a breath and blow. Come out right now. Breathe. Come out, spirit. Come out of there, spirit. Come out of my body right now. Come out of my body right now. Let's go. Come out of my body right now. Go. Get out of that body right this second. Come out right now. I hate you. Come out of that body right now. I hate you. Come out of my body right now. Get out of there. There he goes. Come out of there. There he goes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Get out of there. Come out of my body right now. Hurry up. Come out of me right now. Come out of the Jesus, my demon of fear. Demon of fear, out you go. Demon of fear, out you go. I hate you. I hate you. Come out of my body. I hate you. I hate you. I hate what you've done to me. I hate what you did to my family. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it in Jesus' mighty name. Come out now. Come out right now, hurry up. Satan, come out. Satan, come out. Come out of there. You stop talking to me right now. You stop lying to me. Jesus said you cannot serve two masters. You must hate one of them. Father God, I ask you to give this man of God the gift of faith. I hate you for being in my head. You don't live in my head anymore. You come out of my body right now. Come out in Jesus' name. Get out of there. Come out right now. Get out of my body right now. Say that. Satan, come out. Satan, come out. Satan, come out. Come out of there. Get out of my body right now. Come out. 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 Get out of there. Get out of that body right now. Hurry up. Come out of there right now. There it is. Come out right now. Rebellion. Go. Stupidity. Go. Stupid. Come out of there. Come out. Fight. Fight in Jesus' name. Fight. There it is. Keep coughing. Keep coughing. Come on. Keep coughing. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Come out in Jesus' name. Get out of my head, you backslider. You stinking backslider. Come out of there. Now go. Now go. Go. Get out. Come out. Come on, man. Hurry up. Come on, quicker. Quickly. Quicker. Come out of my head. Come out of that brain. Come on. Get out of my body. I hate you. Come out of there. Stop wasting my life. Stop it. Stop wasting my life. Year after year down the toilet. Come out. Get out of there. Hurry up. Go. Come out. Go. Go. Come out. Come out. You need prayer? You need prayer?
Oh, yeah, to remember all this, to be the life of my family.
Your family got demons? Oh, they're Catholics?
That's demons everywhere.
Yeah,
like slowly going to my Christian church back in
the day. Oh, they are?
Oh, good. So before they were never, like,
oh, good. Now your prayers are being answered. Satan, come out. Get out of there. Get out. Get him out of there. Come out. Now go. Get out of there. You get out of my head right now. Shut up. Deaf and dumb spirit. I hate you. Come out in Jesus' name. Come out, you deaf and dumb devil. Chronic failure. Come out! Get out!
I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the next one.